Assalamu alaikum dear friends, I am Sajid Ali. In my last 13 lectures, we discussed and studied about Indo-Pakistan history. So dear friends, in this lecture we discuss Sir Syed Ahmad Khan. He was a great personality and he was born in 17 October 1817 in Delhi. So dear friends, his father was Mir Muttaqi, who died in 1838. His name was Mir Muttaqi. When his father died in 1838, he became deputy reader. So in 1838, so dear friends, he continued his study and that's why he became sub judge in Fatehpur Sikri in 1841, and he became sub judge at Fatehpur Sikri. So dear friends, and he also became chief judge in 1855 at Bijnor, where he also wrote a book for the history of Muslims, and he died in 27th March 1898. So dear friends, this is a brief biography about Sir Syed Ahmad Khan. He was a great personality and he was kind towards humans, especially Muslims. That's why he fully tried to improve Muslims of subcontinent, and he also tried to remove misunderstanding between British Empire, British government in India, and Indian Muslims also. He wrote 42 books. Some major books we discuss: Asar Sanadid. It was a great book written by Sir Syed. So dear friend, in this book he discuss the old civilization of Delhi and old governments. It was also a pictorial book, Ain-e-Akbari. Ain-e-Akbari was a review of Abul Fazl's book. So dear friend, in this book he discussed the period of Akbar. At first, Abul Fazl was written three volumes about the period of Akbar the Great, who was Mughal emperor, but Sir Syed Ahmad Khan reviewed his books, and especially he rewritten Ain-e-Akbari, his third volume. In that volume, it was written by Abul Fazl and then Syed Ahmad Khan about agriculture of subcontinent and its method. So dear friend, third, causes of Indian revolt. It was written by Syed Ahmad Khan because after the war of independence, misunderstanding between Muslims and British government in India was increased, and a British government realized that Muslims were only their enemies, and Muslims were also became against the policies of British, and they even did not send their children to the schools of British which were established in India. they were totally against British government and they were religious. So after the War of Independence, 1857, Muslims became weak socially, politically, economically, and religiously in India. So dear friends, as I already told you, Sayyid Ahmad was kind towards Muslims. He tried to improve their conditions. That's why he at first wrote Causes of Indian Revolt in 1857 to remove misunderstanding between Indians and a British government, especially between Muslims and a British government. So there were 400 copies were distributed by Sayyid Ahmad Khan, and he also sent 2 copies England at their parliament. And he also wrote Mohammedan, loyal Mohammedan. In this book, he also discussed and explained to positive sides of Muslims and their actions, positive actions towards the British government, and tried to remove misunderstanding also between them. Tabin al-Kalam, it was a book about similarities. In this book, Sayyid Ahmad Khan wrote similarities. He showed similarities between Christianity and Islam, because Britishers were Christians, and there were so many Muslims in living in India, and they totally against to each other, and he tried to remove their misunderstanding through this book, Tabin al-Kalam. In this book, he wrote similarities about Islam and Christianity. So dear friends, Khutbat-e-Ahmadiyya was a reply to William Muir. William Muir wrote a book, Life of Muhammad. In reply, Sayyid Ahmad Khan wrote a long essay, because William Muir to some extent criticized on the character of Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So dear friends, Khutbat-e-Ahmadiyya was a reply to William Muir to his book Life of Muhammad. Scientific Society was established in 1864 at Ghazipur. The main purpose of Scientific Society to translate different books, different scientific books and important books into Urdu language. Those important books which were in different languages, just like Sanskrit, Arabic, Latin, English, or other languages. The purpose of Scientific Society was to translate them into Urdu. And in this way, he tried to improve and boost up Urdu language. Aligarh Institute Gazette, it was a magazine, weekly magazine, introduced in the platform of Scientific Society in 1866. It was in 2 languages. It was a bilingual, English एंड उर्दू. सो द मेन पर्पज ऑफ अलीगढ़ इंस्टीट्यूट गजेट वॉज अवेयर इंडियन पीपल अबाउट द सोशल इशूज एंड पोलिटिकल इशूज. तहजीब अखलाक वॉज अ मैगजीन इंट्रोड्यूस्ड इन 1870 जनवरी बाय सैयद अहमद खान. इट वॉज ऑल्सो इन टू लैंग्वेजेस, इंग्लिश एंड उर्दू. द मेन पर्पज ऑफ तहजीब अखलाक वॉज टू हाईलाइट द सिविलाइजेशंस ऑफ मुस्लिम्स एंड कल्चर ऑफ मुस्लिम्स एंड देयर कंडीशंस एंड ऑल्सो पोलिटिकल इशूज ऑफ इंडिया. सो डियर फ्रेंड्स, वी डिस्कस्ड इंटेलेक्चुअल अचीवमेंट्स ऑफ सैयद अहमद खान एंड नाउ वाट आर द एजुकेशनल सर्विसेज ऑफ सैयद अहमद खान. ही एट फर्स्ट इस्टेब्लिश्ड अ स्कूल एट मुरादाबाद इन 1859. इट वॉज फॉर ऑल कम्युनिटीज, मुस्लिम्स एंड नॉन मुस्लिम्स. एंड देर वर फाइव लैंग्वेजेस वर टाट देयर, संस्कृत, अरबिक, उर्दू, पर्शियन एंड इंग्लिश. इन दिस वे ही ट्राइड टू सर्व इंडियन पीपल स्पेशली मुस्लिम्स एजुकेशनली. He also established a Victoria School in 1862 at Ghazipur. Same languages were taught there also, same subjects also. So dear friends, he also established Mohammedan Anglo-Oriental School. It was a famous and important school because there were many leaders who studied there and they launched movement to create Pakistan, to establish Pakistan, and they understood about their rights after studying there. And after this institute, MAO school, Muslims of India became aware of their rights and they could achieve their rights from government, and they also recognized their foes and friends. So dear friends, MAO school, Mohammedan Anglo Oriental school, was established in 1875 at Aligarh. It was an advanced school as compared to previous school, Muradabad and Victoria. So dear friends, it was inaugurated by William Muir. And MAO school was promoted and upgraded in 1877. It became college. So dear friends, after the death of Sayyid Ahmad Khan in 1920, it became Aligarh Muslim University. So Mohammedan Educational Conference, he also established Mohammedan Educational Conference in 1886. It was a political platform to discuss political issues, especially problems with Muslims and their culture, their religion, and they also find the solutions of their problems. So dear friends, yearly they conducted a meeting of Mohammedan Educational Conference. In a meeting of Mohammedan Educational Conference, Muslim League, a political party, was also established. So thank you very much. In this way, we discussed about Sir Syed Ahmad Khan, his biography and his services, intellectual and educational services also. Inshallah, we will discuss next different topics about Pakistan studies. Take care. Allah Hafiz.